What's up, guys? I'm here in Banff, Alberta, Canada. It wasn't without some trials and tribulations along the way. Okay, so the charger almost ran out of gas, so I stopped over here in Merritt, British Columbia. But now I got some gas, and I'm back on the road towards Banff. The long drive wasn't too much for me to handle, and I'm here, and I got a stunning view from my hotel room. Let me show you what I'm working with here at the Juniper Hotel. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go check out the town, I'm gonna check out some of the lakes, and we're gonna have some fun. Ah yes, Banff, otherwise known as extremely cold place with really pretty mountains. It's right here in the Banff National Park in Alberta, Canada. So joke, I'm from Miami. I mean, there's some major shrinkage going on right now. Jesus. To ensure I don't lose any of my limbs to frostbite, I head over to the mall. Oh, and in case you were wondering, there is a shopping center here. It's called Cascades, or as I like to put it, the place where I come to regain the feeling in my face. So I was freezing and I needed to find myself something. I think this is gonna keep me warm now for the rest of the trip. All right, all bundled up now. Special thanks to Stephanie over here at West Rock. Scott as well, check him out when you're in Banff. All right, say hi.
Hi.
It's a Canadian heist. It's a lot nicer than more normal.
I'm sorry.
Sorry. Well, I'm warmed up, nice and ready. I'm gonna check out some lakes. Unfortunately, Moraine Lake is closed. It's already the first snow of the year, so you can't get to it. But check out Lake Louise, see what's going on with that, and I heard the bars here are pretty good, so I'm gonna take a look at that. Being lazy and not wanting to drive far, I visit Lake Minnewanka, which is right next to Banff. Whew! Ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves a lake. I present to you the one and only Lake Minnewanka. I'm really enjoying this National Geographic moment, but it's time to go back to my hotel room, blast some Nickelback, and get ready for tonight. It's going out time, Banff. Well, unbeknownst to me, Banff is actually one of Canada's party capitals. No idea. And though it is shoulder season, it's November, I heard that the Dancing Sasquatch is the place to be. Yes. The Dancing Sasquatch. Oh, this bed's way too comfy, but I'm gonna go check out Lake Louise now and see what's going on with the day. Gonna go layer up, which in itself is a whole mission here. When I said I needed to layer up, I wasn't kidding. The joys of traveling in Canada. Got the hot dog socks on today. Every time I travel to Canada, I get excited at the prospect of getting Tim Hortons. Ah, yes, you might find it funny, but this cup of love that is laced in maple syrup is truly what makes the Canadian experience that much better. Wayne Gretzky, Pierre Elliott Trudeau, Timothy Hortons. Ah yes, true Canadian heroes. Yes. 40 minutes northwest of Banff is perhaps the most famous lake in the region. You really can't go wrong when you're lake hopping in Alberta. So if your Instagram's gone stale, rent a car and do yourself the favor. You know, it's a lot different of a view than Lake Minnewanka was, but man, Lake Louise, that's oh boy, it's nice. So just a heads up, there's gonna be many tourists and they'll be doing questionable things. Darwin had a lot
going for him. He's a really smart guy. And his theories are always proven true, one way or another.
See that?
Thin ice. See those people right there? This is why Darwin was right. Oh, and there's a giant hotel here too. Say hello to the Fairmount. See, all the coats, everything you wear, everything you do just to get here, the drive, the hours and hours of just feeling like you'll never regain feeling of your face, it's all worth it when you come to a place like this. Whew, that is beautiful. A few things about Banff are, well, pretty obvious. People are really nice. It's stunningly, unbelievably gorgeous. But you always get that sense that you're like in a Disney World of the Rocky Mountains. But you know what? You don't have to go too far to see things that are not touristy and to really feel like it's just you versus the Canadian Rockies.